वेलकम बैक टू जेफ जियो एकेडमी। सो दिस इज प्लानिटरी साइंस लेक्चर 2। सो हियर आई वांट टू टीच यू सम बेसिक थिंग्स व्हिच इज ऑफन आस्क्ड इन द नेट एग्जाम। सो दिस इज इम्पोर्टेंट इन द नेट एग्जाम। सो here I have written two things, one is astronomy and the second one is cosmology. So what is the basic difference between these two? So astronomy means what? Astronomy, it mainly deals with the study of stars. Okay, when we are studying the stars using the branches of science like physics, chemistry, maths, we will call this astronomy. The study of star is the astronomy using the branches of science like physics, chemistry and maths. So it deals with what type of study? So mainly it explain the origin and evolution of the star. So this is the astronomy. Okay, so astronomy, the one who study astronomy it's called astrologers who study stars, their evolution and origin, right? Next one is cosmology. Okay, so the cosmology is what? The cosmology is the scientific study of large scale property of the universe. So when we study the entire universe, okay, when we are studying the entire universe on a large scale, then we call this cosmology. And who is the expert of cosmology is called cosmologist. Okay, now here I want to learn some important terminologies in the planetary science. So in the ancient time the humans believe that Earth is at center and the sun, moon and all other planets are rotating around the Earth. So this is called the geocentric theory, which was completely wrong. Okay, so this geocentric theory was first proven wrong by which scientist? By Copernicus. So he said that actually the Earth is not at center, the sun is at center and all the other planets and moons and the satellites are rotating around the sun, but it was against the church, so he was punished by the church and was hanged to death. Okay, so my point is, when the Earth is at center, which was believed by the ancient humans, then this is called the geocentric theory. Okay, so geocentric means Earth is at center. Very simple. Catch up this. Now, second important term is holocentric. So holocentric means sun center. So when the sun is at center, and all the planets are revolving around the sun, then it is called holocentric. And the third important point is sidereal period. Sidereal period is what? Is the time required by planet to make one revolution and return to the same angular position relative to a fixed star. Okay, so this is what we call year. Okay, 1 year. So in case of planets, this is called sidereal period. Okay, so suppose first I will erase this. Suppose this is sun at center and some planet is revolving around the sun. Suppose it started from here, and after some time it is revolving now, so it will come back to the same position. So this time, this period is called sidereal period. Okay, now perihelion, you may know this. Nearest planetary orbit around sun is the perihelion, and the farthest planetary orbit around sun is the aphelion. Peri means near, and aphe means far. Okay, suppose this is the orbit, sun is situated somewhere here, this is the planet, suppose this is Earth and this is sun. Sun is situated at one of the focus, so this will be nearest and this is the farthest. So nearest, what we called nearest perihelion, so this is perihelion position, and this is farthest, so this is called aphelion position. Clear, right? Now, so perihelion, aphelion, helion, the suffix helion means it refers to some planet. Now G refers to some satellite or moon. Okay, so perigee means nearest point of the orbit of the moon about Earth. So when our moon is situated nearest to the Earth, then it is called perigee position, and when it is situated at a greater distance or farther distance from the Earth, then it is called apogee point. Clear? Now, parallax method. This is important. You may face question from this in your exams. So, what parallax method deals with? So, it deals with the distance of planet from us and the size of planet. Okay. So, using this parallax method, we can calculate both the distance of a planet from us and the size of, what is the size of planet using this. So what is the principle? So this is based on, let this be an arc, let this is the angle theta, so this will be the arc radius, this will be the arc radius, and this will be the arc length, this much. So what is the angle theta? Arc length divided by arc radius, we can find out theta. So using this principle, we are now going to discuss parallax method. Now using this law, we can calculate size of planet and distance from us. Now first I am considering this distance of planet from us. Now suppose this is a star, this is a star, and here is the sun, and this is some planet. Okay, now we have to calculate the distance of this planet. Now this is the formula planets and distance divided by stars and circum is equal to parallax by 360. Okay, now the planets and distance. So this is sun, this is planet, this distance is the planet sun distance. Okay, and the star sun circum is 2 pi d will be equal to parallax, this angle parallax p divided by 360. Now I have calculated, I have to calculate d, the distance. So d will be equal to 360 divided by 2 pi p by solving this equation. Now p, we calculate p in arc second, this is the unit, d in parsecs, p a r s e c x c c s, and a b we can calculate a b in astronomical unit. Okay, now by solving this equation, our final equation will be d is equal to a b divided by p. A b is what? Planet sun distance, and p is what? Parallax. Okay, clear? Now using this we can calculate the size of planet. Remember one thing, 1 degree is equal to pi by 180 radian. Okay, now suppose this is the planet orbit, the planet which I am going to calculate the size. So this is the planet at position A and same planet at position B. Now this is Earth. Suppose this is Earth. Now I have to calculate the size of this planet. So how I can calculate? So this is the distance d from the Earth of this planet. Now here angle theta, it is making some angle theta. Now angle theta is equal to AB divided by d, the distance. Here d is what? Here d will represent the size of the planet. Okay, now thank you. This is the end of the lecture. In the next lecture I will explain Kepler's law, and I am going to start structural geology. Okay, so stay tuned with the channel and subscribe the channel, and subscribe my telegram channel for daily basis quiz, which I have given link in the description.